Elbow Grease Productions in association with MichaelJacksonInsider.com presents Hi, this is Pearl Jr. from MichaelJacksonInsider.com bringing you yet another episode in the life or death of Michael Joe Jackson. This time we're going to be discussing the movie Oz, The Great and Powerful. Now back in July, August 2012, we saw that Paris Jackson had as her profile picture on her Twitter page hot air balloons, and then we had location Emerald City, and that so happens to be the same time that the trailer was released for Oz the Great and Powerful. Now we're coming closer to the release date of the movie, and we have Michael's son Prince being a guest correspondent on ET Entertainment Tonight, in which he interviews the director and two of the actors in Oz. And also very telling is Zach Braff, the actor in Oz, and Paris Jackson tweeting one another. Then we have LaToya reminding us that she is reminded of Michael because Michael was in the Motown production of The Wiz. And then we have the Jackson brothers coincidentally in Australia, which is also called Oz, during their tour. Now, is all that a coincidence, or is that telling us that Michael Joe Jackson is somehow involved in Oz the Great and Powerful? Now, let's move forward to the actual movie. My favorite part, of course, is there are two fake deaths in the movie.
Because I believe in the wizard.
So did I once. Behold! Look! Your wizard!
Where's he going?
He's abandoning us.
How could he?
Not so great and powerful, after all.
Get them all! You left! Move back!
Hey.
Hello, monkey.
Oz! I thought you were dead.
I'm now more powerful than ever. I'm invincible.
I defy you!
Beautifully done, sister. Thank you.
Hurry! You're taking too much time.
Hold. Hold.
They think they're winning. Turn it back on. What? Turn it back on!
Oh, we got a loose wire. Screw stuck.
Hold on. Use this.
Got it.
Right.
You cannot defeat me. I'm immortal. I am the great and powerful Wizard of Oz.
Woo-hoo. So, of course, we're all excited about that. And then we have the use of the words, I'm immortal, I'm invincible, and we know what those two remind us of. So of course we're all excited about that because we are believers and we believe that Michael Jackson faked his death, and we have been led through so many clues to support our thesis that Michael Jackson faked his death. Now, we're going to move forward to all the clues. How about the red royal chair? That's indicative of Michael's chair. And when Oz, his name is Oscar Diggs in the movie, when he sits in the chair, he says, fits like a glove. Wink, wink, nod, nod.
Oh, my scepter.
Oh, yes. Go on then. Have a seat. How does it feel?
Fits like a glove.
And then we have the sunflower, in which we were told 3 years ago that Michael loved sunflowers. And we have butterflies, which represent a new birth, a resurrection, because the caterpillar flies and turns into a butterfly. Then we have the use of the scarecrow, and we know that Michael played the scarecrow in The Wiz, and coincidentally, the scarecrow puts the bad people to sleep. Is that a clue about our propofol? And of course, we were all reminded of Michael's monkey Bubbles because Oscar Diggs, Oz's side partner, was a monkey dressed in a bellhop uniform. How funny is that? And then we have Oscar Diggs being the Wizard of Oz, and he changes his name from Oscar Diggs so that the Wizard of Oz can live.
Remember, Oscar Diggs died so that the Wizard of Oz could live.
Then we have the comparison with P.T. Barnum, because the author of the whole Oz series, including The Wizard of Oz, is named L. Frank Baum, who happened to die on my birthday. That's a coincidence, guys. And my favorite clue is the bubbles when they were traveling inside the bubbles. And that brings us to the Michael album. Because if you look on the Michael album, there's bubbles all over it with things inside, like a gavel, the star for the trial, and a lot of other things. Now, that made me examine the Michael album just a little bit more. So on the side of the Michael album, you see this is it. And coincidentally, they use the phrase, this is it, in Oz, the Great and Powerful.
All right, this is it.
You see the projector camera, which is kind of like the projector camera in Oz. You see a part of a news article from Weekly World News. And if you look at Weekly World News in 1994, they had predicted that Michael Jackson planned to fake his own death. And coincidentally, that article was republished 5 days before the death announcement. And we were told right here in print on June 25th, 2009, the death announcement date, that Michael Jackson faked his death. Also on the Michael album, you will see Peter Pan, which looks just like a young Michael Jackson flying in the air. And if you look on top, you will see the royal chair that is empty that's in the sky. And if you look down a little bit lower, you will see Michael being hugged by an angel, but he is sitting on Earth. So What that means is that Michael is still here on earth and not in his king's chair in heaven. How wonderful is that? And the best part of the Michael album is right there where he says, "Read my lips." It says, "I live." Some people see alive, but definitely "I live" is right there on Michael's lips. And to further prove that this is all a setup, did you notice the Cirque du Soleil logo on the Michael album? Michael Jackson Immortal and the new upcoming Michael Jackson 1 Cirque du Soleil shows. Well, guys, that's it for now. This is Pearl Jr. for MichaelJacksonInsider.com, and be sure to rush out and see Oz the Great and Powerful.
We have nothing to fear as long as we believe.
Thousands believed Tupac did it. Millions believed Elvis did it. But did Michael Jackson really do it? E-movie book, Suicide: Did Michael Jackson Fake His Death to Save His Life? By author Pearl Jr. It's the most shocking true story of our lifetime. Order yours today. Go to MichaelJacksonSuicide.com. That's MichaelJacksonSuicide.com. Picture on her Twitter page, hot air balloons. And then we had location, Emerald City. And that so happens to be the same time that the trailer was released for Oz the Great and Powerful. Now we're coming closer to the release date of the movie, and we have Michael's son Prince being a guest correspondent on ET Entertainment Tonight, in which he interviews the director, and is also called Oz, during their tour. Now, is all that a coincidence, or is that telling us that Michael Joe Jackson is somehow involved in Oz the Great and Powerful? Now, let's move forward to the actual movie. My favorite part, of course, is there are two fake deaths in the movie. Two of the actors in Oz. And also very telling is Zach Braff, the actor in Oz, and Paris Jackson tweeting one another. Then we have LaToya reminding us that she is reminded of Michael because Michael was in the Motown production of The Wiz. And then we have the Jackson brothers coincidentally in Australia, which... Hi, this is Pearl Jr. for MichaelJacksonInsider.com, bringing you yet another episode in the life or death of Michael Joe Jackson. This time we're going to be discussing the movie Oz, the Great and Powerful. Now, back in July, August 2012, we saw that Paris Jackson had as her profile picture. Elbow Grease Productions, in association with MichaelJacksonInsider.com, presents...